Hello, my beautiful Scorpio friends. You have your mind made up coming into this reading that you are going to make dramatic changes. The Death card, Scorpio, is your opening card for the whole reading. As I do the overview of the reading, and I took a peek at the cards here, you are making life-altering decisions. You don't do so carelessly. You're very cautious. There's a piece of you that doesn't want to quite let go. But my, oh my, Scorpio, you are reinventing your life to suit your needs, your desires, and to give you the happiness that you have been craving for a very long time. So let's jump into this reading and see what is happening for you. We have the energy of take time to breathe out. Disseminating moon. It is that initial feeling that you have when you say, I just want to throw everything out. You want to start your life completely over and live it in a way that you've never lived your life currently. I get the energy of the queen bee. Many of you have our parents. Many of you are leaders in the workplace. The queen bee is who everybody turns to find out what they're supposed to be doing. Many of you are high-level executives. You're very successful. You could be running an empire, or you could just be managing a family that is fully grown, and you want to make very dramatic changes. Now, what's interesting about the energy for you is that you are of two minds here. What that means is that the life that you have is pretty darn amazing. The life that you've already built is something that you want to change dramatically, and yet you know that you will be giving up things that you truly love, things that you truly value. So I like this card for you because of two minds makes me think of Libra energy. We get with the enlightenment of Aquarius coming in at this time with Saturn and Aquarius. I feel as though your career is the area in which you're feeling this tension, this thought that, you know, at the end of the day, you don't really want to give something up that's been so good to you, that's fed you in such a profound way, emotionally, psychologically, your family, monetarily. But we also see Swan Spirit here. We see that it is time to take a deep dive. Now, Scorpio, imagine that, a water sign taking a deep dive. So you are really going inside. You're taking a journey, an inner journey. What we see here is that you are ascending the mountain. Keep going forward. You know that you're headed in the right direction, but there's a piece of you that says, I'm not sure I'm ready to go quite yet. And when we have the opening reading, of course, again, as I mentioned momentarily or a few moments ago, you have the Death card here with all of this blossoming new growth, death and rebirth. That is your approach for the year. That is what's going to happen, but it's what's going to work for you. People see you as a person who can virtually do anything. When we look at your seventh house for Scorpio risings, we see the King of Wands. We see a love interest that's fiery, that's sexy, that's fun, that's powerful. Somebody who could challenge you. Somebody who feels as powerful as you are in their own way. We see the Sun. We see the Death card. And so what I'm seeing here is that you have a complete rebirth. You rebirth through Scorpionic energy by, you know, going inside, diving deep. But we also see a love, a lover, a love interest, a partner, a business partner, a lawyer, a financial advisor, somebody who has a legal relationship with you that's literally going to help you see how to inject your life with more fun, with more larger than life. They're going to show you the path, really, of how to get where you want to go. This person holds a roadmap and very key information for you. I say that because I see the Sun card next to it, which is Leo energy. Leo energy. So you may be dealing with a Leo Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, but I feel as though you may attract a partner into your life, be it business, be it marriage, probably both, that's going to really make you question everything that you want in your life currently. When we look at your earned income, you have many options, Scorpio. There are many things that you'd like to do. You have had a great career for the most part. You know, you're in this mindset of, gosh, if I give up what I already have, I've worked so hard to get it, will that be foolish? You're wondering. You don't know what the right answer is as you enter the year. Pisces energy, though, is water sign energy. You have a magic wand. You have options. The Sun card tells me that your partner in life, your cohort, whoever you partner with, be it business or a personal relationship, the two of you are placing a very high value on pure joy, pure happiness, living a quality life, living larger than life is what I wanted to say. I've done many videos today. When we get this energy of the Sun card, it's the happiest card in the deck. It rules the fifth house. It's romantic. It's sexy. It's being creative. And you are going to be rewarded in the house of Scorpio. Whatever you invest in, your partner is bringing in a lot of abundance here. But we see that whatever you're going to create together with this eighth house energy, that is getting loans from people for business propositions. It may be 401k, pension assets. You have an abundance of money and resources to do what you want to do. You need to merely make the right choice, but making the right choice with the Seven of Cups tells us that there's only one right choice out of seven, so you must be careful. When we look at your neighborhood, your siblings, we look at the Devil card. It looks as though you're feeling very tied down right now in terms of a contract, your work life. It looks as though you have probably a friend that you work with that you don't want to let down. So therefore, again, you are of two minds. Very much people rely on you. They feel as though you're the person with the wisdom. It is Gemini energy. It's intellectual energy. It speaks of contracts. Like I said, if you have siblings, I see siblings may leaving you to some very heavy responsibilities with parents, perhaps. When we look at the Justice card, we look at contracts. We look at you in a larger framework. Many of you may have the opportunity to teach at a very high level. Some of you may go to law school. Some of you may be in the process of reframing your life in a way that allows you to teach at university, to have contracts internationally, because this is a house. This is your local neighborhood, and this is a house of foreign places. You may want to establish a corporation or a business in a foreign land, a different country, different culture, a place where it would be very different. So it looks as though you're trying to land a very special lifestyle for yourself. when we look at your heritage, your home, the people that you love, Eight of Pentacles, it's very sound. You know, you're still in this energy of truly, you might still be raising children. The Eight of Pentacles is also the house of expertise, of learning. And part of what I see here is that you're in the energy with that fourth house of really still being very invested, possibly in motherhood, possibly in nurturing others. The Eight of Pentacles is also about teaching what you know, handing that legacy of knowledge to future generations. The energy of your 10th house of career is the Empress. No wonder you're of two minds. This person comes in with wonderful opportunities, ideas, things that send your mind racing, but you have this exquisite career, this Empress energy. It is Taurus energy. It gives you an abundance of money, a lifestyle that's great, but you are tired of being tied down. So we see you in the energy of Aquarius, the Star card, in your fifth house of romance, of children, of creative ideas, children of your mind, children of your body. The Star card tells me that you are very blessed at this time, that you have healed any old wounds, anything that you've wanted to accomplish, hopes and dreams for a creative endeavor, romance, love are coming true for you, Scorpio. You are ascending. We see that in your partnership, in your, this is romance. This is the fifth house of Leo, all right? And we see the World card, you going to the next level. I feel as though your partner who's coming in here may be somebody who is highly successful, that you've been highly successful working on projects with this person, and you now want to create something new, exquisite, extraordinary on the world, in the world stage, the world at large. It speaks to the greater good, something with a humanitarian bent. You are very, very set in this strong desire to be the queen bee, to take a deep dive, but in a different direction, ascending, more of a spiritual journey in which you can help mankind. We look at your everyday life, your health, your wellness, how you solve problems. This is Virgo entered. This is a house of Virgo. Three of Pentacles. It looks as though you will be able to maintain a working collaboration, a source of income that may give you more than one source of income. And we see the Page of Cups. You are offered a chance to delve into a fantasy or a wish. It's Pisces energy, something that you've always wanted to do. It could perhaps be with children or young people, some sort of humanitarian goal to help others heal. It is an energy, Scorpio, uniquely about you, because at the end of the day, you are the surgeons who can cut the toxicity out. You can rebirth. You can bring people and situations back to life. That is your talent. That is who you are. Let's look at the energy that we see with the El Goliath deck. It's a shadow deck. So this may help us take the deep dive into why you feel sort of very drawn and tied to not wanting to leave this wonderful life you've created and yet being pulled forward to do so, because it's what you find exhilarating. So the first card out is a Ten of Swords. So there may be an ending that's very painful. There may be someone in your life that you feel has simply cut you out of their life. It could be anyone. Let's go ahead and clarify that energy for you. Why is the Ten of Swords here for Scorpio in a shadow energy that they're trying to work through? It's something that you've invested in. It's a situation, Six of Cups. So you've invested very soundly with a long period of time with probably friends or a career in business that may be coming to an end. It may end abruptly because your friend or whoever you're dealing with in this business may simply decide to take a different direction. It may impact you quite suddenly. But look at this. We get the Six of Cups and the Six of Cups. You really wish your person well. It may not quite be what you want to see. It may come as a surprise to you. It may even feel very almost tragic to you. But we get the Six of Cups. That is a soulmate. That is a dear friend that you've had for a very long time. For some of you, there may be some sort of loss that's bigger that I'm not seeing in very specific terms. But it would be like maybe a friend says, look it, you know, I've got to go. I have to go somewhere else. I have to do something else. I think I need to shut the business down. It comes as a surprise to you, but you have the option to keep working. You have the option to come up with a partnership agreement of some sort. The karmic soul tribe, you feel very tied to your history. You know very much that you're going to receive the good karma that you've created. You've brought so much abundance to many people through your efforts, through the magic that is you, through that sun energy. We also see the Seven of Cups again. You're really confused as to how to deal with this energy, how to deal with the situation. The Death card says that there is an ending. There is something that feels painful to you. The Ten of Swords is painful, but we see the butterfly. It opens a whole new life for you. Something that you've been trying to ignore. You've been trying to ignore the fact that you knew that this was going to happen most likely. The Two of Swords is when we just say, you know, I'm not ready yet. But now, regardless of whether ready or not, here the future comes. And what you can expect from it is the ascension up the mountain. Let's look and see the energy of a situation or relationship. A brand new beginning, the Fool card. Well, what else would come after the Death card? What else would come after the Ten of Swords? Of course, a new beginning. Once again, the Death card is making an appearance. Three times now in your reading, Scorpio, you are going to have a lot of power in this transcendent situation. Your heart is still with the people that were, you know, you're thinking about, people that you're involved with. We have that Five of Cups, but look at the Emperor is right here. We have the Emperor and the Empress. I feel as though that is your divine partner. I feel as though that's what's happening. The Moon card says that although you don't see this coming, you know, it's smoky trails, it's darkness in the night, it's Piscean energy, but here we go. The Ace of Coins is the reward, is the offer. The Ace of Coins is an abundant new life path for you to take upon yourself. When we look at the Six of Cups, we're looking at dear friends. So there may be some sort of challenge in that regard. But that Ace of Coins points the way. The Ace of Coins points the way for a great deal of happiness and abundance. So what you don't see coming right now is a very dramatic change to a much more joyful financial endeavor, which is going to bring a lot of healing, a lot of success, and even recognition on the world stage. Scorpio, it's an incredible year ahead. I'm delighted that you've shared your energy with me. Cindy, you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. Leave a comment. I always answer them. Wishing you the happiest, most abundant, fearless, and powerful 2022. Let me know in the comments as the year progresses what happened. Sending you love. Bye-bye.